Hey everybody, this is Simply Wargaming here, and today I'm going to be showing you how to build this pocket-sized Lego candy machine. Unlike some of the other machines I've built on Brick Ultra, this one has no Technic pieces, so I'd say almost anyone will be able to build it. Now I'll quickly show you how it works. So if you take pretty much the smallest coin that you have in your currency, so something like this American penny, 2.5 studs in diameter, and just push it into this hole here, till it drops. Now on the machine's side, you can see this little white bar. Just push that back and you get a gobstopper. Now if you want to see exactly how this machine works, I suggest that you go to the video. It's in the description, and that will take you to my channel, and then you'll be able to see that video on exactly how to reload and collect the coins and so forth. Now without further ado, let's get into the tutorial. So for the first step, need to take a 6x8 plate and then attach three of these 2x2 smooth tiles on top. And I suggest that you make these the same colour as the plate and the walls so that you can't tell where the coin bank is going to be. Now we're going to build up a layer of bricks around all of this. So as you can see, basically I've filled in all of the area without the tiles with blue bricks. Now we're going to build up a little ramp which the candy falls out. So you can start off with these two bricks here. So they're 2x1 sloped pieces. And we're just going to put those, right here. Now it looks really good if they alternate colours, because then we're going to take a 2x2 brick and place it on here, and then of course another two of these, and this time I put them on in the opposite order. Now to finish off this look, I'm going to take two 2x1 smooth tiles and once again put them in alternate colours, like so. So now we can take aside this piece and begin building the coin bank wall. So start off with a 2x6 plate and attach on top three of these 2x1 bricks. You'll notice that one of them has a hole in the center to allow easy removal of the coin bank. And this one goes in the center like so. And then we attach the other two bricks. Now we take a 1x6 brick, put that on top, and then we're going to make three of these bricks that you can see here. So they are essentially the same as a 2x1 brick, but they're built up so they don't have studs. So you take two 2x1 tile pieces and then a 2x1 smooth tile on top. Make sure one of them's green and put that one in the center. So that's if you're actually doing the design. And then the other two just go on the outsides. So that's all you have to do for the coin bank. Now we can bring back in this piece. So we're going to build the two towers that are on the side of the candy falling out area. And basically they are 1x1 round pieces, and you get six of those and stack them on top of each other in the alternating pattern. And you make two of those and just put them on either side of these smooth tiles. Then we can continue by building up some layers of walls. So now I'm going to take two of these reverse slope bricks and we'll attach them to the dispensing area, like so. Once again, we can build up another layer of walls. So now you can take this 1x4 smooth piece and just put it right here. Then we're going to build these two pieces here. So start off with this 1x3 and just attach a 1x2 smooth plate. It's fairly simple. And this one is a 2x2 with a 1x2 smooth plate and a 2x2 smooth plate attached. Now if we bring this back in, so taking this piece first, it goes on there. And if we just remove that 2x2 quickly, we can then place the second piece there like so. Then we get the 2x2 back on top. Now you'll notice that there's a fairly large gap here. And basically you'll actually put a 1x4 green brick as soon as we build up the next layer. Next you take a 1x2 smooth tile, put it on here, like so. Now I'm going to build up another layer of walls. Now we can take this piece aside again and we're going to start building this dispensing piece. So get a 1x4 and two 1x2s. And just put them in this C shape. Then we can take two 1x3s and attach these to the 1x4. Like so, and then just fill in that gap with a 1x2. Then we take another 1x4, place it there, and two more 1x2s. And then we just cover the top with smooth tiles and ensure that you have a 2x2 tile here facing out like that. Now we can take this piece back in and also grab this. Now, depending on what coin you're using, will change this piece. So if you're using something like the Australian 5 cent, you just want the 1x1 with the slope on top. If you happen to be using like an American penny, attach just a 1x1 plate on top, and that just makes it slightly better for the penny, which is a little bit smaller. If you don't know, just test with both and then just place this here. Now we're going to build up another layer of walls. Now make sure you notice that I didn't place a brick here. Rather, we're going to take a 2x1 tile and put that there. Once again, we can take away this piece and we're going to build this part here. So we're going to start off by building that same C shape again. Then we're going to take two 1x4s and attach them like so. And of course a 1x2. Then we grab a 1x1 there and a 1x4. Then we take two 1x1s, put those there, and then add a 1x3, then take a 1x2, and then finally just two stacks of two 1x2s on the end, and that's the result there. Then we're going to quickly add on a layer of brick. So just take a 1x4 onto the end and then two 1x2s. Like that. And then we cover the top with tiles. Now we take this piece and that piece. And so first we get this piece, and it goes inside here, like so. Then we take this piece and just put that on top. Like that. Now we're going to build this piece here. It's as simple as taking a 1x3 plate, attaching smooth pieces to the top. Then we're going to take two 1x1s and put them on like so. Now this piece is the bar that goes in here. Now we can build up another layer of walls. Okay, so now we are going to build this piece. So start off by taking this 1x4 and then have two 1x2 bricks. So one of them is green and that is on purpose. And have it like so. Then we can add a 1x1 brick. The only reason mine is a tile is because I couldn't actually find any 1x1 blue bricks. Don't really know where they went. And then we can take a 1x6, place that directly on top. Finally, we just build up another layer. So a 1x2, and then a 1x3, and a 1x2. Now this piece fits on like so. Then we can grab two 1x6 bricks and just place them on the sides. And then fill in this area with a 1x3 and a 1x2. Now we're going to make four more bricks. So these have a 1x6 and then two 1x2 tiles on the top in the center. Then this type has exactly the same, but it's only one 1x2 tile in the center. And basically these ones go on the front and back. And these ones go on the side. Like so. Now we can take four of these 2x2 plates and attach one to each corner. Finally, take a 4x6 blue plate and put that on top, and then a 4x6 green plate, or if you don't have that, just make do with whatever pieces you do have. And then we can take this 2x2 white brick and put it on top. And finally, you can grab the coin bank and slot that in. So thanks guys for watching. This pretty much concludes the tutorial. Hope you found it easier to build and that you enjoyed the video. So make sure to subscribe to Brick Ultra, subscribe to me, Simply Wargaming, and of course like the video.